From paintings that seem like they're portals to another world, to some of the earliest depictions of cows, here are the most unbelievable cave paintings.
Hey guys, how's it going? I'm your host, American Eye, keeping an eye on everything you want to know.
Sego Canyon Petroglyphs, Utah. The Sego Canyon Petroglyphs are on the sandstone cliffs of Sego Canyon, Utah, showcasing 8,000-year-old haunting life-size images of people with hollow or missing eyes. They're often missing limbs, too. It's certainly a mystery how they've lasted for so long, and what exactly the ancient tribesmen were trying to represent. Many scientists firmly believe that these were religious visions by shaman during a trance-like state and were documented on this cliff. But is it possible that these religious visions were actually real, and these could be evidence of visitation by aliens? These phantom-like images are certainly some of the most bizarre cave paintings known to man. Petroglyphs of Sloan Canyon, Nevada. Located south of Las Vegas, the petroglyphs of Sloan Canyon are often overlooked by the petroglyphs at the Valley of Fire or Red Rock Canyon. However, these should not be overlooked and are some of the best preserved petroglyphs in the western United States. It's not really a tourist-friendly attraction, and the Sloan Canyon Conservation Area was basically created to keep people out rather than to keep them in. Some date back to 12,000 years ago and requires an intense 2 to 3 mile hike to reach. Much of the artwork is open to interpretation, and some of them might even make you wonder if the Paiute who lived here might have had some kind of contact with extraterrestrials. It's believed the valley was actually filled with more water at one point in time, meaning that it was much more habitable than it is now. Caves of the Hands, Argentina. At the bottom of South America, in Argentina, lies a mysterious work of art left by our ancient ancestors 10,000 years ago. Inside this cave, many handprints were left in a creepy fashion. It's believed that hunters sprayed their hands and left negative images of their handprints all across the wall. Many of them overlap each other, and it almost seems like some kind of lost soul trying to reach their way to the underworld. What it's supposed to represent hasn't been figured out completely. Many claim it was a ritual before taking part in a hunting expedition. Others believe it was an initiation ritual that was performed after they were accepted as a part of the clan. Another enigma is how they lasted for so many centuries. The Anasazi Cave Art. The Anasazi people were a Native American people who lived in the pueblos of the Southwest, more specifically in the Four Corners region since 1200 BC. These hunter and gatherer people later on developed advanced technology in agriculture, cultivating maize, beans, and squash. They had a prominent knowledge of celestial science, which helped them decide where to place buildings. They didn't call themselves the Anasazi, but were given this name by the Navajo, meaning ancient enemies. They seemed to enjoy a high standard of living for Native Americans until they mysteriously vanished in 1200 AD. Why would they build these remarkable cliff dwellings only to disappear not too long after? They left many of their possessions at home as if they were planning on returning. Here you see some of the mysterious cave carvings by this culture. Some seem to think that it was some kind of portal to another world. Others claim they disappeared due to drought, but not enough remains were discovered to suggest this theory. Wangina Rock Art, Australia. This spooky rock art was found in Western Australia and was created by Aboriginal tribes who would have had no Western influence of our depiction of aliens. Despite this, you'll find the petroglyphs of what seems to be very similar to how we would describe an alien. With large heads, big eyes, and oddly shaped body, these paintings were extremely important to them. They were even given several coats of painting. The Aboriginals claimed that they were the weather gods who had the capability of creating rainfall. The rock shelters of Benbetka, India. Traces of human life were uncovered in central India that date back to the Stone Age. The rock shelters were home to primitive humans and acted as great places for shelter about 13,000 years ago. There were a total of 760 rock shelters here, many of which contain remarkable cave paintings, as you can imagine. What's quite interesting about this is that it shows people possibly riding on horseback, suggesting some kind of knowledge of domesticating animals. It would also appear as though they would inhabit the caves here for quite some time, possibly until the early Bronze Age. This painting here appears to show a man hunting a horned boar. Getting your hands on a juicy boar back during the Stone Age would have been an exciting event, but also dangerous if you end up getting attacked. The Acacus Mountains, Libya. This mountain range in the center of the Sahara forms between countries of Libya and Algeria. It's here where you'll find a large variation of strange dune and rock formations like the Rock Arc and Tadrat. This is also where you would find the ancient rock art of the Sahara, or what's left of it. The paintings depicted giraffes, elephants, ostriches, and horses, and it dates back to 12,000 BC. The UNESCO State of Conservation reported a large amount of vandalism with sledgehammers that appeared to intentionally inflict damage upon the paintings. Many of them were also looted. This happened when the country was under a little bit of political chaos. Tassili Niger, Algeria. Located not too far away from the Caucasus Mountains is a vast plateau which contains ancient artwork within. It's believed that this area was covered in much more water than it is today, and once some ice water melted during the Ice Age, there was a decent amount of rivers here. Although many of the landscapes are mesmerizing, what really brought a lot of attention to the area was all the cave art. About 15,000 petroglyphs were discovered and displays about 10,000 years worth of artwork. There is a wide display of images here, which includes some of the earliest depictions of humans as well. In addition to the paintings, there are also many carvings in stone. One of my favorites is this one species of cow that lived in Africa, which is now extinct. Lascaux Caves, France. Who knew that a teenager could find some of the most important prehistoric artwork just by following their dog into an opening of a cave? The rock art at Lascaux in southwestern France has been described as one of the most important cultural assets in the history of humanity. The way it was discovered, too, was also quite amazing. But now no one here is allowed to enter the caves to check it out. It was discovered by a French person named Marcel Ravida in 1940, and they returned with a few friends to check it out. All of his friends were amazed by the discovery and seemed like the caves were unexplored for thousands of years, and they were right. The cave contains nearly 2,000 images that date back to 17,000 BC. Over 900 of these images can be identified as animals, and it allows for archaeologists to know what animals roamed Europe at this time. That includes animals such as large cats and bison. We all know it's a very fragile piece of artwork, but could there be some ancient history documented in this cave that they don't want us to know about? Coso Rock Art, California. This next set of cave paintings comes from the Golden State and is actually on federal land at the China Lake Naval Air Weapons Station. Public access to see the petroglyphs can be granted, but only with approval of the Navy. Since it's found on a military base, there's kind of a double-edged sword for those who want to see it. On one hand, the artwork will be reserved for years to come, since it's a difficult site to access, and vandals won't take the risk of trespassing. On the other hand, you gotta get permission, and it could be closed to foreign nationals. There are some really interesting works of art here that likely date back to 13,000 BC. Some depictions like we see here show flocks of bighorn sheep, which would have been their prime source of protein. The art was created by the group of Coso Indians who inhabited North America at that time. Some theorize that the artists were under the influence of mind-altering substances that helped them become more creative. Horseshoe Canyon Rock Art, Utah. Horseshoe Canyon is one of the most well-known rock art locations in North America, and for good reason. Near the rock shelter wall is where you'll find the largest panel of Barrier Canyon-style pictographs. It measures over 200 feet long and is about 15 feet high, so that's a lot of pictographs. It's also referred to as the Horseshoe Canyon Great Gallery. Some of the images in red come off rather ghostly. The things portrayed here seem lifelike in a sense because most of the paintings are about the size of a person. Humans had inhabited Horseshoe Canyon as far back as 9000 BC, when Paleo-Indians could survive off eating large mammals such as mammoth and mastodons. The main gallery, though, dates back to anywhere from 900 to 2000 years ago. Most of the figures have a solid red body, almost as if they were using paint from the blood of their enemies. And number 1, Lost Gil, Somalia. This next location on the continent of Africa has some of the best preserved cave paintings in the world, and it's quite impressive to say the least. The name Lost Gil translates into a source of water for camels, and it was known to be a great area for nomads to graze their animals. There was a lot of open land here, and not too much threats to humans at that time, so it must have been a peaceful place to live. The site is placed on a granite outcrop which rises from a plateau at an altitude of 3,116 feet. It was discovered by a group of French archaeologists who seemed rather convinced that cavemen and cavewomen inhabited the area. There are roughly 20 rock shelters that contain paintings, with some of the bigger ones measuring about 30 feet long. Most of the paintings include images of cows and not a whole lot else. Some are believed to represent dogs and a few of giraffes. Too bad we can't go back in time and ask some of these people what the heck they were trying to draw.
Whoa, now that was a cool video. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.